When we're asked to evaluate an equation, we have a few different ways we can do it. One way, like the original way we first learned how to do it, was when they gave us a value for x, for example, we literally just plugged in 3 for x. So we could do that in a calculator, we could do that by hand, we could evaluate and we can get a number as an answer. Remember, they may also give this kind of notation, find f of 3. It means the same thing, plug in 3 for x. One way that we've looked at this year that was a little bit quicker than evaluating by hand was just using the table on our graphing calculator. So you could type this equation into your y equals screen like you were going to graph it, but then rather than going to your graph, go to your table and look up x is 3 and find the y value. A third way that we can do this, we'll take a look at in this video, is called synthetic substitution. Now it sounds like synthetic division, and there's a reason for that. It's because it's the exact same thing. So if you know synthetic division, you know how to do synthetic substitution. Let me just show you what you're looking for as the answer. So the way synthetic substitution works is take the value you want to evaluate with. So in this case, it's a 3. Now we do not change that value, we just use a 3. In the past with synthetic division, we sometimes change signs. With substitution, whatever you're plugging in is what goes in the box. List your coefficients in order, noting any terms that are missing. So in this case, I see that my exponents are in order, 4, 3, and then a first power and a constant, but I'm noticing I'm missing the 0 x squared, I'm missing the x squared term, so I must absolutely put a 0 in place of that, otherwise it will be wrong. So let's list out our coefficients. It's 2, and then negative 5, 0 for the x squared, it's gotta be there, negative 4, and finally the constant of 8. So at this point, we're just going to do synthetic division, although we're calling it synthetic substitution right now because we're not really dividing, but whatever, it's the same thing. So drop that first number straight below the line, so 2 drops straight down. Multiply what's below the line by what's in the box. 2 times 3 gets you a 6, and then add those the numbers in the column together. So negative 5 plus 6 is 1, and then repeat till you run out of numbers. So 1 times 3 is 3, add those values together. And repeat, 3 times 3 is 9, add those values together, repeat, 5 times 3 is 15, and then 8 plus 15 is 23. Now in the past with synthetic division, all those numbers were important. It turns out with synthetic substitution, we care about one and only one number, and that is the very last number, what we would have called the remainder if we were doing division. That's the value we would get if we plugged 3 into that equation. So it may be a quicker way to substitute. If you have a graphing calculator, probably graphing and looking at your table will be your best bet. But if you need a quick way to plug in some values and you don't want to do it by hand, try the synthetic substitution trick. It's pretty cool. If I want to write my answer a few different ways, I can say that, you know, f of 3 is equal to 23. If I looked up this in my calculator in the table, and you may want to just check that this actually does work, I'm not lying to you, look up 3 in the x column, you'll see 23 in the y column. But that's how it works. Do synthetic division and just look at your last number, and that's going to be your value you get if you sub that in by hand.